and he shall bring you back to life, and in the end shall gather you unto himself. The cousin of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, said about this ayah that the part where it says you were dead means that you were actually in the backs of your fathers, meaning that you had not been born yet. You were contained inside of there. So you had not yet been born into this world as alive. So according to the standards of this world, you were dead. And he says that then he brought you to life. That means that you were born from the wombs of your mothers. And it said, then he caused you to die, which means you were interred in the earth, and shall bring you back to life, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, and that is the ba'ath, the resurrection. And in the end shall gather you unto himself. Now this is the position of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, who is the first cousin of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and studied the Qur'an with all of its meanings and nuances three times with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I should also like to mention that this is also the position of Imam Abu Ja'far al-Tabari, rahimahullah, who mentioned in his Jami'u al-Bayan wa Ta'wil in Volume 1, the same position under this ayah. It is also the position of Imam Ahmed al-Qurtubi, rahimahullah, the great Maliki scholar and saint, in his Jami'u al-Ahkam al-Qur'an, Volume 1, under this ayah. It is the position of Imam Ibn Kathir, under his Tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim, Volume 1. And is also the position of Imam Ahmed al-Sawi, the great Maliki master and theologian, in his Hashya al-Jalilain, Volume 1, under the same ayah. So by looking at these, we can see that this is the understanding of Orthodox Islam as passed down. As far as the other ayah, that it gives you life and then causes you to die, it is he who will gather you all on the day of resurrection, as mentioned in Surah Al-Jathiyah, ayah 26. This is actually proof in our favor, because it's mentioning that when you die, you will be brought back for the day of resurrection, which means that there is no rolling cycle. There is no reincarnation. You are continuing on. Once you die, then you will be resurrected, and then that will be the day of resurrection. So there is no cycle. And those that seek to escape the cycle, those that seek to escape the day of resurrection, believe in this cycle, for they believe by doing that, they are absolved of all responsibility, and that they will not have to worry about the dread and terror of standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their sins. But let me tell you, there is no escape, as these very two ayat that they quoted are burning evidence against them. Now, these two ayat we've spoken about, but we also want to say, what else has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about reincarnation and belief in it? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may not have mentioned the words tanasukh or raja, but he most assuredly must have alluded to that fact. So what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master, the creator of all, what has he said about reincarnation? What does he think of it? What does he want us to know of it? He says, وَاللَّهُ أَنْبَتَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ نَبَاتًا. And Allah has caused you to grow from the earth like vegetation. ثُمَّ يَعِيدُكُمْ فِيهَا وَيَخْرِجُكُمْ إِخْرَاجًا. Then he will cause you to return there and will bring you forth for the next time. Surah Nuh, the 71st surah, ayat 17 through 18. Notice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned nothing of a cycle. He mentions further, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another proof, which is an amazing evidence, when we consider it and read it carefully, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah As-Saffat, which is the 37th surah, ayat 58 through 61, he says the following, أَفَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَيِّتِينَ إِلَّا مَوْتَنَا الْأَوْلَى وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُعَذِّبِينَ إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ لَمِثْلِ هَذَا فَلْيَعْمَلِ الْعَامِلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Is it the case that we shall not die except for our first death, and that we shall not be punished? This is very clear. They say, is it the case that we shall not die except for our first death, and that we shall not be punished? Notice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this ayah the first death only. There is no other. Our Lord and Master and Cherisher and Preserver has told us further about this phenomenon and has again refuted reincarnation yet again. And Surah Al-A'raf, the 7th Surah, Ayah 53. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the following, هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا تَأْوِيلَهُ يَوْمَ يَأْتِي تَأْوِيلُهُ يَقُولُ الَّذِينَ نَسُوهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ قَدْ جَاءَتْ رُسُلُ رَبِّنَا بِالْحَقِّ فَهَلْ لَنَا مِنْ شُفَعَاءَ فَيَشْفَعُوا لَنَا أَوْ نُرَدُّ فَنَعْمَلَ غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلُ قَدْ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَضَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ Surah Al-A'raf, the 7th Surah, Ayah 53. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, are they waiting for its fulfillment? On the day it is fulfilled, those who have forgotten it will say, indeed the messengers of our Lord brought the truth. Is there anyone who can intercede on our behalf? Or could we be sent back so that we might do differently from what we had done before? But they have lost their souls, and that which they did led them astray. Surah Al-A'raf, the 7th Surah, Ayah 53. So here we are, back at the same juncture again, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the judgment is once. There is no escape. There is no getting away from the fact of resurrection and standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bearing an account. There is no way possible to escape Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's judgment. Another ayah is from Surah Al-Mu'minun, the 23rd Surah, Ayah 38. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again tells us, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا رَجُلُ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا وَمَا نَحْنُ لَهُ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, I will quote the 37th ayah first, where it says, إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نُمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا الرَّجُلُ الْفَرَىٰ عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا وَمَا نَحْنُ لَهُ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ It says, actually, the only life is this one. We live, we die, and will not be resurrected. Surah Al-Mu'minun, Ayat 37 to 38. And the interesting thing is that the actual idol-worshipping Arabs in the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had no concept whatsoever of reincarnation. It is true that they did believe that when you died, you were finished, most of them, and that life was completely shut off for you. But there is no history of them, at least the great and vast majority of them, believing in reincarnation. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us again in the same surah, the 23rd surah, in Ayat 19:9 to 100, he says the same grim outlook for those that died without professing the faith of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدُهُمُ الْمَوْتُ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ كَلَّا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون Taken from Surah Al-Mu'minun, the 23rd Surah, Ayat 99-100. It says, until death comes to any one of them, he says, My Lord, allow me to return so that I might do righteous deeds in the things that I neglected. But by no means. It is only a word spoken. In front of them is a barrier until the day they will be resurrected. Surah Al-Mu'minun, Ayat 99 to 100.